Hello everyone, Sean here again with Scred Red. Made a bunch of tweaks since the last video. Yesterday's video. I guess not a bunch, but some small ones that I think probably make a big difference. I cut down the roast and mindstone count to 3 each, and I've upped the stormgrass count to 1, and I've added a land. Still not 100% on this yet, or I still feel like I'm in the, experimental phase. But, this definitely feels better so far, and, so I feel like I'm getting there, I'm getting toward the end, so to speak. I felt like, Reckoner, I felt like I needed more, another mountain to make that work, and the Mind Stone was kind of getting in the way. I also swapped the Angers for Pyroclasm because Anger, I kind of overlooked that it destroys Reckoners, so I went all in on Pyroclasm. And that makes the curve better too. I had I had too many 3 drops, and then when I switched over to the Pyroclasm, then I had too many 2 drops. So, done a bunch of tweaking, now the curve's pretty even. Now we have more threats with the added Storm Breath, and just all around feels pretty tight right now. Again, it's a work in progress. I upped the Crumble to Dust count because the sideboarding is smoother against Tron. I forget what I board out. Board out the roast, I believe. I can't remember. I had some kind of plan. Anyway, we bring in 3 crumbles now. Much better. So we need the help against Tron. It might be a roast that I take out and bring in the 4. So everything else feels pretty good to me at the moment. I believe I cut down on the claws, which is fine. I think I take out the roast for that, or maybe even Mindstone, and it just swaps evenly. The only thing I'm thinking about is upping the Vandal Blast count probably to 3, and possibly even switching it to Shattering Spree, back to Shattering Spree, so it's a little more flexible. Pros and cons to both. I like that Shattering Spree's a little quicker, you know what I mean? You don't have to get to 5 to be able to use it. But anyway, I don't know. We'll see. And yeah, I might up that to 3, I'm not sure. I'm not sure what I'd cut, if anything, but partly because Affinity right now is very high in the meta, so we do have, I feel like a pretty good game against them. The Pyroclasms help a lot, but anyway, that's what I'm thinking right now, but for the moment, I'm happy with this. Anyway, so I'm doing a league event. I did already do 1 round, and I didn't record it. So I'll just give you the gist of it. I played against Lantern, and basically I beat him with Boris Reckoner and Scred. He had Ensnaring Bridges out, and I think I played Scred on Reckoner and did like 13, and then played another Reckoner and did it. I think he misplayed a few times. Like he didn't bottom a Reckoner when he could have, and there was once... There was a couple of occasions where he got rid of his Lantern to get rid of a card on top of my library when he didn't have another Lantern, and he wasn't like under immediate threat, like it wasn't, I forget exactly what was on top. I think once it might have been a Koth, I don't know, so I guess you can make a case either way, but there's at least one situation where he shouldn't have done that, and he did. Like, he gave up his Lanterns too easily. So, yeah. That's the gist of that. So I won that. I thought it was 2-0, but I guess with Lantern, everything's kind of a blur. Just the kind of deck, it's, even when you beat it, it doesn't feel that good, because you're just, like, so worn out. The game I lost, yeah, I think he just locked me out, you know, whatever, typical stuff. He got all the pieces. quick and I didn't have the answers, etc. So yeah, I'm really eager to get this deck finished, quote-unquote finished, so I don't feel like it's 100%, and I really can't wait to make it 100%, because I feel like it could be really, really strong once I get it there. I had a plan versus Tron, and I'm trying to remember what it is now, like what the sideboard plan is, because I don't want to keep it in, I don't think there's any reason to keep it in Pyroclasm, so it's like, what do you bring in? And I don't think I want four crumbles, that's just ridiculous. Even three feels like it might be too much. But it's probably the right amount, I don't know. Take it the roast, and maybe I just leave in the pyroglasms for the hell of it. Just for lack of better sideboarding plans. Or do I take out the glasm and bring in spell bomb? I think that's what I did. Yeah, that must be it. And then, Blast, I guess I would bring in. Seems better than Relic, which doesn't do much, so I'd probably take out two Relics, bring in two Blast. So it's a decent plan, it's still awkward, you got two Relics there that don't do anything. But, it's not bad. It's better than it was, that's for sure, so. Do-do-do. Feels like the right thread count. I'm not sure that we want four Storm Breath. Three feels like that happy medium. Like you kind of treat it like a 7 drop, and you don't want 4 7 drops. I think I talked a bit about this last video, but and then it's kind of like a, like if it was like a true 5 drop, then I guess you would want 4, or you might. But because it's kind of a 7 drop too, then, you know, you end up at 3, and it just feels right. Because I've had lots of games where I feel like, you know, I want, there's a fair amount of games where I think I had 2 Storm Breath, or I just had the 4 Koth and the 4 Storm Breath, and I just felt like I needed more threats, so it seems like 11 threats is nice. I would consider cutting land and going to 4 Storm Breath, but I feel like then if you have 4, then you definitely want 24. I already kind of feel like 24 is the right amount, so it doesn't really work. Anyway, I don't feel like I'm missing out on a ton by not having the 4 Storm Breath, and it might even be correct regardless. Anyway, I think now it's just down to basically playing, I think, a bunch of games and figuring out the sideboard. I think the main board might be done. I'll do land challenge for my liking, so I'm going to mull a bit aggressively. Eat much better. Bottom. I can't believe there's any debate about Boris Reckoner. It's just, like, you need a certain threat density, and, it's just, like, what else do you use, you know, besides your, you know, your 5 drop? Yeah, that's gonna die. Bye-bye. So, Mute Vault is very strange. looks like black red. Rabble Master is bad unless we draw Pyroclasm. Damn it. Four. Koth is looking bad right now. So he would swing for exactly four. Attempting to do it anyway, just to buy me some time. I think we do it. There's a chance we draw a Pyroclasm, so 2, 3, 4, well, he could swing at the Mutavault too and kill it. 2, 3, 4, that's still 6 coming at me. I don't want to go to 13, so for lack of a better option. 3. And we get in a bit of damage, save a bit of life, so it's far from optimal, but it's what we got. And it also sort of forces him to use Mutavault, I think. Oh no, he goes to 4. I thought he started at 4. That's my bad. So he can just swing with those 4. For each other attacking. Jeez, that's brutal. Yep. Nothing for you. Storm Breath. So it looks like just a weird black-red control. I guess he's going like, yeah, this Mutavault just seems incorrect to me. That's weird. I would much rather like Ghost Quarter Attack Edge. You don't want Dark Confidant and Mutavault in the same deck, you know? It's just weird. You're a mid-range deck, not an aggro deck. And even in an aggro deck, Mutavault is weird. Just taking the damage. Or do we 3, 4, 5, 6. Two, three, four, five, six. Oh, it's a goblin, that's why the synergy. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Like, that's insane. I don't think we have a choice. So we just try to block the Rabble Master. And hopefully it doesn't have Terminate. Oh my god. God damn it, all to hell. Oh god. Jesus. So we need a Pyroclasm or we die. That's all there is to it. Like, we do have some draw. So, come on. I got 4 in the deck. Come on. Oh my god. We don't have enough mana to, 3 to crack Mind Stone, so. Begin combat. I just want to double check the duel settings. Begin, yep. It says at the beginning of combat, so let's stop it on the main phase, I guess. At the beginning of combat on your turn, yep. I guess he actually doesn't have much. He has to pay for Pact, and these two are going to be dead. Oh, he's swinging for 4 anyway. Fuck. God damn it. And there's nothing for 1 that can save me. Let's see what the next card is. Yeah. You, sir, are insane. volume doesn't seem great. It does turn off his mute vault, I guess, but still, I'd rather more removal. Possibly more Dragon's Claw. Siege seems kind of good. This deck can be so fast. Like, if we have the Klazim, it's fine, but if we don't, like, I don't know, I guess we just didn't have the removal at the right time. So, I'm not sure what to do. Do we cut either the Mind Stone or the Roast? Or actually, relics are bad. Great, that's for sure. Yeah. Okay, let's hope this goes better. Yeah, looks pretty solid. And he mulls, so. And he puts it on bottom, so. Much better start. Colgan's command can hurt us a lot. Lava Claw reaches, huh? Yeah, that seems to make a lot more sense than Mutavault. Well, again, the Goblin synergy, but still, even though with that, that's a little too all-in for my taste. Yeah, let's do that. And then Reckoner, well, seems great against the Goblins. Bolt it without taking three. Could terminate though. Sounds good to me. That outpost siege is gonna be amazing. Unless he thought seizes. I don't think he has a way to destroy it. Okay, yeah, I'm cool with that. So we're gonna have to hold off on the siege. So, it's very debatable whether to use the Scred or the Spell Bomb. Because we could save this for a Reckoner, but we also kind of want to save this for the draw. But we got Outpost Siege, so there you go. That's the answer. I suppose I should have waited till his main phase, whatever. And yeah, the claw's doing some work for sure. Plus X plus O, so that swings for two. So I would love it if he swung with that right now. Rabble Master again. Combat. So it should pause here. Okay, thank you. Fuck you and your Rabble Master. I'm loving Claw right now. And the Siege is gonna just put me on top. hates that card. I don't think there's anything that can kill it. Black and red, I don't think can deal with enchantments, period. Unless you count, like... No. I crack the earth, like, technically can destroy it. Ooh, he's answering my, siege with a siege of his own. So that's very bad for me. And I can't deal with it right now. So, Storm Breath, I guess, would be the perfect draw. I'd be pretty happy with a Koth as well. Or a Reckoner actually would do it too. I could, come on, baby. Not... no. It's gonna hurt. Thought we had it. We could still have it, but... rough. Maybe 24 land is too much. That's bad. Don't want to use that right now. Save it for his reaches. Now he knows he can swing freely. Oh, Jesus. That is brutal. So Pyroclasm. Oh my god. Yeah, I'm cutting the land count. Enough of this. This is too much. We're going to 4 Storm Breath. My rule of thumb, you might have heard this if you watch my ARAC videos, is don't Inquisition Thoughts, Easterets, etc. unless you know, unless there are 2 unknown cards. If there's only 1 unknown card, it's not worth it. That's my opinion anyway. Unless, you know, there's exceptions like the... I mean, we have a healthy life total, I guess, but, like, look at this shit. This is ridiculous. And he could Lily Ultimate, I guess, too. Eight. Boris Reckoner would be amazing right now. Could block this shit and, do, like, 8 damage. Well, it could destroy Planeswalker. Is insane in top deck mode, and he's just gonna copy it, so we're fucked. Jesus Christ, look at all this shit. He's gonna... don't really have a choice. Pyroclasm would be great, and that's the only thing that gives us a chance, I think. Ugh, you fuck! And he just goes crazy with the rat next turn. That, like, even Pyroclasm I don't think could save us now. Chandra. interesting. There are times I want more wrath. Maybe four isn't enough. Might put two in the board. But it feels like it should be enough, you know, four, that's plenty. Especially if you have a siege, I should be drawing this by now. We'll keep it for now, but there definitely have been a few games where I've wanted the wrath and haven't drawn it. Oh, that's brutal. Oh, never mind. I thought it could destroy enchantments for some reason. See, if I was him, I would definitely not do that. He should be playing around Pyroclasm. He should have kept mana open for rats. Right now, if I get the Pyroclasm, I buy myself a lot of time, which I do not. So I think it's tempting to go with the Confidant, but it feels like just to have a chance, we have to kill the rat just to buy us. But it's also like, let's see, 3-6. 3-6. Oh my god, that's insane. I think we just die next turn if we don't kill a rat. 3-6, he can do it twice. Yeah, so it's just an obscene amount of damage. It's just strange to me that 24 land is too much, because Jund runs 24 and it never seems to have too much land, and the curve is similar. Or maybe it's not, I don't know. You know, like, you're in a bad spot when you have to bolt a pack rather that's already been copied. To my storm breath anyway, so let's call it a day. That was bad. So I guess what card? Electricry. Because I don't want to run, like, Anger. Two mana does one, to everything. Like, most stuff these days is one toughness. I almost want to run, put some Electricry in the board, but that seems pretty bad. And I'm trying to think of red spells that deal 2 damage to everything, and let's just, like, what else? What else is there? Volcanic Fallout, but that doesn't matter. That card is not important. Sorcery. Let's just keep it loose. Maybe we'll find some interesting things. Deal 2 damage. Is it? What's the wording to creatures? Deal 2 damage creature. 6 to kind of keep it kind of loose, because sometimes you find like fun stuff, like with weird costs, or like gonna have a look at the maybe board. I hope you guys don't mind this stuff. I mean, personally, I like to, here's what we could run. What is it? I guess forked bolt. 2 damage. Like, that could be decent. And what's the other one? Arc Trail? I think it's Arc Trail. 2 damage, strike creature players, 2 and 1. So, like, those seem pretty good. So I'll probably put those in the maybe board. And then I guess we could, but I'm trying to think of decks where we want those kind of cards. Where we don't want another one drop or another, or one of these 2 drops. I mean, Roast and Mindstone are pretty flexible, so Arc Trail would be decent. Like, we want Scred and Bolt against those decks. We could take some of them out, so that's fine, just to, like, upgrade the removal. But Relic, I think, we want Relic against most of those decks. But yeah, I might find room for an Arc Trail or a Forked Bolt. Probably just, like, one of each. Or one of either or. I mean, see, I like to do a bit of kind of live brewing. I put timestamps in the description, if you guys haven't noticed. So you can skip all this stuff. You can just, if you're not interested, which I would understand if you're not, but I would understand if you are too. Lavamancer, Stag Shard, 2 damage, Dark Return Player. I think those are probably the best options, Forked Bolt and Arc Trail. I kind of want to run Dead Gone. Like, I'm wondering if there are creatures we can't deal with. I mean, there must be, but I can't really think of any. If anyone else can think of any, because I want an excuse to run this card. I like the flexibility, because I wish we could fuse it. Unfortunately, we can't, but yeah, I like how flexible this is. So if there's creatures we can't deal with, then we have this to help with that, and then, you know, that's your standard 2 damage. Is that in the maybe board? Dead Gone. Let's pop one in the maybe board. I had it in there, but I took it out. I almost thought about this. Well, I did think about it, and it's not the worst, but I decided it was not worth it. Much going on here, really. Rolling Timbler is actually not terrible, but I don't think worth it, and also anti-synergistic with their relics. So yeah, I don't really think there's much. The Bolt and the Arc Trail seem like the best bet. Might find room for those. And that would probably give us less Well,
no.
It might help with certain matches where we have like a lot of like dead cards, like with Tron, for example. We could take up more stuff and just bring in those, like bring in an Arc Trail. It's not the best, but it's probably better than what we're doing right now. Yeah, the sideboard is almost always the most difficult for me to figure out. Probably most people, really. Like, there's so many things you have to consider. The main board is relatively linear, you know? It's, like, focused on your, you know, your primary plan, and that's easy enough to throw together. A lot of decks tend to kind of come together, but the sideboard is a whole different animal. Nice hand, yes. Pretty much a perfect hand, really. Another thing I've been considering. You would take the Mind Stone. I don't really care. You can take his pick. Interesting. So this makes it bigger, I believe, right? By the time it resolves. He's knowingly trying to trick me right now, I think. Termogoyf Bolt. There's probably a thing about it. Try, but I will not fall for your shenanigans, sir. So a relic would come in real handy right now. Damn it. I might have taken the Storm Breath, but I suppose it's likely he has a plan for that. Yeah, I really have to switch down to 23 land, so I guess we're going to 4 Storm Breath. Which I think I'm comfortable with. I'm guessing he has Terminate. Certainly tempting to relic, but I think we'll just suffer. I'm really surprised it's not dead. Yeah, I think he should have, he made a mistake, I think, and, or unless he doesn't mind taking the damage. Oh, he's sacking it, yeah. Okay. And then he gets in the damage with the bolt, so, yeah, that makes sense. Should've, ooh, damn it. unfortunately I can't afford to take the damage. So we're gonna have to moon next turn. Land, no land in the graveyard, so that's gonna get big. I would like to, very much like to keep my... Oh, we get to draw with the relic though, so there's that. Get to bolt the Goyf. That's troublesome. It would probably be, do we do it now or do we do it next turn? We just discard whatever we draw off the relic, possibly the bolt. Because I might want to kill this Raging Ravine. Prefer to just neutralize it, the Blood Moon, but if he attacks with it, I don't know that we have a choice. Unfortunately, we have to do this. The Goyf does buy some. If we let the Goyf live, we do have a longer clock, I suppose. Any Bolt just kills me. Way too many lines on this deck. Look at this shit. This is consistently happened to me, so I think it just proves. Oh my gosh. I guess like if we Storm Breath, we need 7, so we need 12. That's interesting. He's cut off green, so I feel like sack. Those are good piles. Both feel incorrect. Figures. I feel like he has a Goyf in hand and he wants to land it, so. I feel like I made the correct choice. There's a small chance we steal this game. Not steal it, but win by the skin of our teeth, rather. 3, this grid certainly helps. This Blood Moon is doing serious work. That's bad. I think I'll wait to... I'm not sure why that's not showing up. It's tempting to kill it. But I feel like I want to wait and see if he'll block. Damn it. Oh, he knows I have Koth. Interesting. Oh wait, I can still Koth, right? Yeah, I just can't attack with the thing. So yeah, sure, let's... He takes 3. So I have to do this or I die, right? Yeah, you would take 3, so I really don't want to do that, but I have to. But yeah, I'm actually in a very good spot. Please don't top deck Bolt or something, but feels like he doesn't have it. Ooh, that's bad. Oh, we can -2 and swing with the Storm Breath. And he only has red mana, right? So he would have to, and he clearly doesn't have the Bolt, so I think we're just good. 4/4. Right, I need to double check here. Yep. Seems right. I thought he had 5 power for some reason. Well, he can't... I guess he can attack with that, but... Don't know that he wants to. He wouldn't die from the Reckoner damage, I don't think. He's probably trying to figure out how it works too. Or actually, because would the first strike affect it at all? Or do we even want to do the first strike whenever it's dealt damage? I think it matters. Now the question is, do we kill it or do we do the three to it? I think we have to do, well, he would only gain three, and that would still put him in range. So I could put two counters. I feel like I want more outs. Although he could have a terminate, and if he does, then that just kind of screws me. I don't know that there's a right choice here. Oh, actually, he can't, he could just put two counters on it, right? Three, he would take six. Sacrifice another vampire or zombie. Well, he only has the one creature, so that would be useless. Two, he would be at six, and he would still die. So... if it's correct, but that's what we're doing. I'm playing around Terminate, basically, I think. Thank you. Five. So the question is, do we, we could minus two and just use this. And he would take, he might take three, but I feel like we want to give him, like if this dies, then I just, that's it. Take three. I don't know. I feel like I just go for it and swing with two creatures in case he kills one, the other one just dies. I think that's correct. Because I feel like if he had two removal spells, he would have used them by now. Please die. Yes. Knew it. I think I played correctly there. Feels nice to be rewarded. I think Siege is the only thing I want. I think I'll keep in the Blood Moons. He might play around it, but still. Not sure what to take out for Siege. We take out a land. Let's do that. Bolt. Spell bomb. I don't think there's anything I'd rather, so I think we'll go with that. Pyroclasm is not amazing, but I don't know that there's there's anything better, really. Could be good. I'll be right back. Spell bombs. Pyroclasm? Or roast? I think I'm going with the pyroclasm. Actually, fuck. We need the roast for, like, that vampire dude. I don't know why that Dark Confidant art is not showing up. Must be a bug. I think I like the snow-covered mountain because we got scrying sheets. Sort of like pyroclasm. Pretty good, except for that lily. We need a threat like right now. Here. 1, 2, 3, we're at 4 mana. That Raging Ravine's kind of breathing down our neck here. I guess I like the roast, and I kind of like, cracking the limestone here. That would put us at 4 mana. And then we could potentially get more scrying sheets. Yeah, I guess we'll do that. So this and this combined is worrisome. He doesn't have another red source though, so there's that. Praying I don't draw Blood Moon. It does turn off his, I was gonna crack that anyway, you silly bastard. That's cool. Hopefully I draw the fifth land and almost kill her. And put her out of, come on. And then she get minus two. Fuck. What? I thought I was at... Did I discard a land? Why would I discard a... Oh my god, I messed up. Really messed up. Do we crack the relic? I think we do. It's tempting to sheets, but... If we draw land, yes, then we can sheets still. But yeah, this is desperate. I messed up discarding that land. That was a huge misplay. And I messed up not boarding out the Blood Moons. Although, like I said, it does turn on Ravine, so that's something. So, I like roast here. We just get rid of the Goyf. We need these threats. I like that Koth gets around. For minus two. Land would be nice. Yes, thank you so much. I really love scrying sheets. Four. That still puts her at two. She can sack. So that's bad. On the other hand, he can swing with this next turn for four and just kill the Koth. Four. Next turn, that would be a disaster, so I think we just have to sack to Stormbreath. At least it gets rid of the Lily. And then, yep. Unless he terminates it, of course, but, you know. Gotta play to your outs. Oh yeah, he doesn't have a... he's out of cards. So, it's pretty even right now, actually. Ooh, that's... well, it's... not many creatures in the yard right now, just the one. So we'll get rid of the Goyf at least, right? Yep. 4, 5, 6. he'll kill the Koth, but yeah, he's definitely at an advantage right now. Don't have much choice here. I wish we could protect it. His ultimate is amazing, by the way. It really gets you out of, like, a lot of jams. Like, it's very clutch, you know? Sometimes, you, like right now, I really need a fast clock. If I could ultimate him right now, it would really turn things around, and it would also... And it's like, it's something they can't interact with, so... Apart from, like, Boom Bust, but, you know... Pretty desperate right now, so I don't really feel like holding back lands. So, yeah, he's gonna massively... quick clock on me. So, four... What is it? That's how I'm dead next turn. I don't even know if there's a way out of this. I really don't think so. Yeah, that's game. Okay, let's take out the Blood Moon. And I think I just poured in Spell Bombs. Yep. They can deal with an ooze that can't get counters on it. Deal with Goy sometimes. Dark Confidant, and possibly other stuff, so. I can cycle as well, which is nice. If you could fuse Dead Gone, that would be insane. I would possibly run... I would run it for sure, and I might run multiple copies. Ugh. I don't know. I mean, I guess Klasm is pretty good early game. Deals with Goyf and stuff. And this gets better as the game goes on. That gets better. We get the Mind Stone. It's okay. I got mixed feelings. But I think we'll keep it. We only got 5 minutes left. Jeez. Holy crap. I take a long time. I am a slow player. I think it's... It took forever with that, Kalidus play, or whatever it was. Yep, sure. Hand like this you don't want them to see. Yeah, he knows his hand sucks, so he's taking the draw. Cycle that. That's bad. Three. We could 2-for-1 ourselves to kill it. Ooh, or we just do this. I mean, I think we just cycle it right now. Anyway. 4-5. Three. So probably Scred next turn. Or not Scred. If he makes this bigger, I might Scred, and if he doesn't. If he gets us to like 3 power or more, if that's even possible. And I suppose that would do it. That's going to make that an artifact, so that'll get bigger. It'll be out of range, right? So I think we have to cycle next turn. 3-4. Oh, that's an instant. That'll still make it bigger. 3-4. So yeah, we got no options right now. We just cycle it anyway. Make it a 4-5, though. God, this fucking card is frustrating. 4. Oh, no, it's, no, yeah, no, there's no instant. So, yeah. What do we do? I think we Clasm and Bolt. He's happy with that. I would like him to swing with this. I would not like that to happen. This is miserable. Now I kind of wish I left it in the Blood Moon. Who the hell is texting my face off? 4. Yep. 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 Maybe we just leave in the Blood Moons. I don't know. I guess if we have something like really great to bring in for the Blood Moon that's good against them, then we. See, I don't know. 4. Yeah, so we'll wait for him to. No, he has nothing, so. Might as well. At least we got that. And he's gonna ult him the next turn and just completely fuck me. This game. Right? I don't know. I guess we'll just wait. But I don't see any reason not to ultimate here. Bring it down to 2 lands. Yeah, it's a little surprising. I would have ultimated for sure. Well, maybe not. I guess if he figures I can kill that. But what would I kill it with, you know? So. And too little too late. That was bad. Let's try again. So we had 2 more, so yeah, the best we can do is break even. So another rough day for Scred. I do feel like the board could use some tweaking. Not really sure what it needs. It's possible it needs cards that aren't printed yet. by the way. Secret deck, Aura Barbs. There's a lot of auras in your deck, in your meta, sorry. This card is sweet. It's usually a pretty small part of the meta, though, so not worth it. Yeah. And it only hits one deck, and you need multiples, so it's like... But, you know, it's fun. If you got a free slot and, or more, and the deck gives you a hard time, then it's probably worth it. That's a problem. All of this is too slow. Problem with snow-covered mountains too is most people know what you're playing as soon as you drop one. Well, not, maybe not most, but a lot of people. Drop Skred next turn, probably. Or we could drop the Reckoner. I'm inclined to drop Skred, though. The lack of Anger of the Gods is going to hurt here, but then you have Reckoners to make up for it, I suppose, so... Playing, oh, it must be a Domain Zoo. It's got four colors going here, so. Oh, so he's screwed on lands, which is nice for me. So... I don't think he cares about his graveyard, so I like the idea of cycling this and playing Skred. Could play Reckoner, but I'd rather not trade. I don't know if this deck plays counterspells. I'm gonna assume not. Seems weird. Gonna assume it plays Geist. Be playing Counter Cat. I don't think I've ever played against that. But I don't think Counter Cat is four colors, so. Ugh. I guess I could wait on the relic. There's not really a need right now. There is a chance he cares about the graveyard. 2-3. Yep. So Reckoner and these relics first ability, so it's very nice here. And then we have First Strike or Bolt Mana open. Yeah, like you feel a little bad about not playing Anger with this, but then like he makes up for it because he can either trade or even just indefinitely block three power guys, three toughness guys right there. That feels bad. Okay, but on the other hand, it means we could play Stormbreath next turn. The Pro White is relevant against him. Yeah, I don't care about 3-4. So do we bolt the Loam Lion? So that would be a 3-4. Like, yeah, I think we bolt the Loam Lion and then I guess I'll swing two with Goyf. We could Klasm next turn. Oops. I think we can still shrink that, right? 3-4. Oh, yeah. Oh, we could have responded to the Exalted. My bad. Also Reckoner and just trade. And kill it that way, but it seems like Stormbreath is the way to go, and I don't think there's a way for him to kill it, so apart from attacking and then bolting, but then he has to give up his guy, so but he could make this big though. That's another point too. Could be a reason to attack. 3-4. Chance it. He would need, I mean, there's already instants, so he would need land or a sorcery. I don't even know this, I doubt this deck plays sorceries. He could have Boros Drum here. Call his bluff, partly because I have a second Stormbreath if he manages to get rid of this. Boros Drum would be bad. Yeah, I'm okay with that. Very okay with that. Yep, thank you, thank you. Yeah, I got the better end of that deal. I believe. So I think Reckoner. Green, blue, white. He's got everything. So I like Reckoner because it's faster. not really a question here. Moon swing for 7 next turn. Seems sweet against this card, potentially. Not right now, but in the weak Chlasm, because it's a 1/2. Ooh. So he doesn't have much. I like the idea of 5/6. Things we could do. I'm trying to figure out if I can kill the Loam Lion with Pyroclasm somehow, but no. So I feel like we have to roast it. Actually, we could just Mind Stone, Storm Breath, swing with Storm Breath, lean back, leave back Reckoner. Oh, but then he would swing with the dude and make it a 3/4. So swing it for 4. I feel like we can chance it here. We just go on the aggressive. Very tempting to Pyroclasm though, but we can do it next turn. Oh no, but he might double block. Yeah, that's fine too, isn't it? It'll kill a bunch of stuff. I thoroughly enjoy this deck. So we do 7, and then we can roast. Let's see, roast the Reckoner. Yes. Yeah, that felt right. Tempting as it was to, 2-for-1 him, it was not correct. Kind of like Dragon's Claw here. Chlasm seems pretty bad. So I feel like we take out the Chlasm. Yep. 4 claws. And this also doesn't do much. So I like bringing in a siege. That feels great. Yeah. I like this matchup. Oh, that is brutal. Yeah, I'm gonna mull as well. I'm on the draw and I get the scry, so this is infinitely better. Oh, and he mulls to 5, so we're probably good here. Ooh, Koth. Yeah, let's go with that. Koth is a bit bad against aggro decks, is the thing. Or it can be. If you have enough control, like, you want to establish control and then drop him, but if you're kind of, like, in between, or if you're on the back foot, he's really bad. I wish the, if the thing lasted until the next turn, that would be super amazing. So turn 1 bolt is great against this, much better than Skred. I think I've said this like 50 times, but I'm so happy Reckoner. I also wish Mindstone didn't require you to tap it to cycle it. It'd be so much better. Maybe too good, I don't know. Okay, I feel like we cough if we get aggressive. It's not like he can discard my siege. It's possibly his revelry to destroy this, but yeah, I think we get aggressive. We drop this later. And we want to start, you want to ultimate this as soon as possible, if possible. Now what are you doing? What are you doing, sir? What could you possibly be up to? Oh my god, he doesn't have a counterspell. Are you serious? He is playing Countercat. Does he run like... Brutal. Luckily we have more. If I had known that he plays counterspells, because it really didn't seem like he did, I thought he was just playing blue for Geist and possibly, what is it? That Tribal Flames? 3, 4, 5. So he may just path that, but we have lots of action, so I'm okay if he does. Yep. The extra mana would help right now, so we could cycle these happily. I might turn this to 2 at some point. Right now I'm... 3 seems good, but... only so everything's even, but... yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yeah, so we'll do this. So we have mana to cycle this, we'll do that end of turn almost definitely. I don't even know if he can't kill this. This card feels amazing. Can't kill it, blocks everything. Not everything, jeez, I'm getting a bit cocky. But, blocks his, lion, no problem. Got him right where I want him. Wow. Wow. 4, 5, 6. So I think I want to hang on to the mana. Actually, fuck, I should have held on to that, actually. I wasn't thinking about the monstrous. That would be sweet right now. He would do exactly 10 if he didn't do anything about it. But, you know, we could be in a much worse spot, so. Anyway. This, we still have mana for scrying sheets. Well, the Boris Reckoner is a home in Modern. It's making me happy. I love that he discourages bolts and encourages ramp. Both of which are welcome. We can usually find use for the path mana, as you can see here. So, lots of mana sinks. Yep. So now we can activate that next turn. Sometimes I do wish there was kind of a protection spell in here, like a Boros Drum would be sweet, but it's not worth it to splash. Yep. So the question is now whether to Mindstone or to Scrying Sheets. I'm pretty sure it's Mindstone. 4, 5, 6, 7, yeah. We would like a threat as soon as possible. Blood Moon is nasty. 5, 6, 7. So we can Blood Moon and Oppo Siege. So that's absolutely nasty right now. And now I don't think he can even deal with this, even if he brought in revelry. Oh my god. Love this deck. When it's firing on all cylinders like this, it just feels so good. Unfortunately, Skrid doesn't do anything right now. And I would like this to work, but such is life. Bolt is certainly not too shabby, though. It's definitely worth it to turn off the sheets, though, to turn off all these. So he's off green and blue. He still has the red and white. Damn it. I thought that was on top. Oh, it exiles and now it's a new card. I see. Right, it's not like a draw. Okay, 6, 7. I don't think there's really a reason to play lands. Reckoner right now would be... Well, it would have been nice if we had it before. Well, even now it would be great. We could Roast and Bolt. Pester. Sure. If only to... the off chance he destroys the first one, and also to, you know, well, yeah, it doesn't actually dig through the deck, I guess. It digs automatically whether or not you play, which is kind of cool. It's good and bad, because you would kind of like, I don't know, I'm not 100% sure what I'm trying to say here. I should have dropped a land. Oh, I already dropped one, right? You know, we got tons of land. 4, 7, 8. We go up to 9. It's pretty soon we're going to be able to drop that Storm Breath and activate it. Ooh. Great. Popular tonight. It's not usually the case. Yes, I would like to play first. Yes. This hand makes me pretty happy. I feel like keep a bolt in case we're playing against burn or something. And it's not like we have anything to do on turn two at the moment. This is not... This is a sketchy hand versus Affinity. I don't think he wants to sack all this shit. 1, 2. I guess just in case we keep a double bolt, so then we can make him sack everything. Counters on it, right, and then 4, so we'll bolt that in response. There we go, now he's got nothing. We had to use 2 cards, but you know, we're in decent shape here. Ooh, that's bad. Yeah. So this can't actually block anything. We could potentially draw another bolt or scred. Nope. No such luck. But still, I don't know. Was that incorrect? Wow. flying. So we're just gonna die. I don't know. I was kind of banking on him not having much else in his hand. Could have been incorrect, but I don't know. I could see it going either way. Anyone who has tons of experience against Affinity, let me know. I don't usually. This is my first red deck, like I said. Not making excuses or anything, but. 8, 9, 10. And then he can make that 11. 8, 9, 10, 11. Yep. Savage. Nothing I could do. 34 life, holy shit. Okay, then a blast. Helms, want to take out the storm breath? Definitely want to take out the blood moon. This is another situation, see, where an Arc Trail or a Forked Bolt would be amazing. Or I think they're both sorcery, right? Yeah, but still, I think the instant speed versions are like 3 mana, so fuck that. So Affinity sideboarding is awkward. Yeah, third Vandal Blast would be perfect. So I guess we're gonna have to do that. I don't know. Like, do we just keep the relic? Yeah, I think we just keep the relic just to make the opening hand a bit more capable. Is this okay? Not really what I want against Affinity. Really banking hard on the Pyroclasm. On this one, I'm gonna mull. It's not much, that's basically the same hand, right? So put that on bottom. We're really just praying for a Pyroclasm here. Like, we want Skrid, we want Lightning Bolt, Spell Bomb, and especially. Pyroclasm. Trying to think if there's other things I would take out. Yeah, there's plenty of things I might take out for an Arc Trail or a Forked Bolt. Or maybe we just put in the Forked Bolt instead of the Vandal Blast, and then that's our third spell. Or fourth, rather. Because we can use that against a bunch of stuff. So I do sort of like that. Oh dear. Four. Going all in, hoping for Pyroclasm. He can still deal with that, but. He's gonna put everything, I guess, like on this guy, probably. I don't know. Oh, yeah, that makes sense, because then he can still use that. Rockbound Ravager is absolutely insane. Just, like, a ridiculous amount of value. Certainly it's one of the main reasons Affinity can survive all the hate. So... now I would probably be... Thoughtcast? Now I'd probably be happy to... draw Vandalblast. Even though I can't cast it this turn, now it might be too late. Jeez, he's gonna do a ridiculous amount of damage. And then he can also just... do the Ravager, Ink Moth plan. So, I don't know if there's a way out of this. I wish there was an instant speed. Red Artifact Wrath. I checked, and fortunately there's not. That would be sweet. That's a card they could print. So I don't know if he tries to save this, or if he just leaves it, or what. Yeah, he just puts it on that. That makes sense, because he knows he's probably got me with this Ink Moth plan. Oh dear. Sort of feeling Shattering Spree. Yeah, he can kill me. Oh, I should have not F6'd. Because now he knows he can go all in. Surprised. So, I don't know that even Vandalblast can save us right now. Yeah, no, we don't have the mana. And I have nothing to kill this. So, yeah. So, another bit of a rough day. Definitely made some mistakes, and the sideboard is definitely not optimal. And we do get screwed by having too many lands. So, to start, we're gonna do this. Possibly we could mainboard the Oppo Siege, but I don't like that. Too many fast decks right now. And there's always fast decks, so... So this seems right. And I do think I like Shattering Spree. Best, and it's some slightly torn between going with three or going with two and just putting in like an Arc Trail or a Forked Bolt. take out. Guess we could take out a spell bomb, but not sure how smoothly it would sideboard, but it's probably worth it if we decide to go in on something else. So, yeah, for now, this seems pretty good to me. I feel like we would have done, it would have made a difference today. We might have won 3 matches, possibly even 4. So, that's where we're at for now. As always, interested in your guys' feedback, any thoughts, etc. Hope you enjoyed watching, and I'll see you again soon.